Thoughts from the bath, part two. So anyway. I may not be an authority on the things I talk about. I may not be an authority, but I have done a lot of research and I do have a fairly good wealth of knowledge to share. And since so many viewers are brutal, I'm just going to attach some playlists to some of my videos, maybe have some more of these lamenting videos, but I'm going to attach some playlists, all right? Some playlists from people who do know what they're talking about. I'll be a sharer of information. And you don't have to believe anything I'm telling you. I don't want you to, literally. My stupid hair. Don't believe anything I'm saying, seriously. Don't believe me. But give the information a chance. Look this shit up. I'll provide some links and stuff to some really good videos of interest, people who do know what they're talking about. Michael Tesarian, Mark Passio, Harold Kautz. Yeah. I'll just link to people who do know what they're talking about and just share the information. And from there, you can go and look this stuff up on your own. Gauge what you think. What do you think's the case? What do you think's real, you know? I never said to just believe me. Don't believe me. But give this shit a chance. Don't be so close-minded. Don't be a crawfish. I always talk about crawfish. A scientist I used to be friends with. Who we ended up falling out real, real bad. Because he wanted to diss me, and I mean diss the shit out of me. He wanted to diss me because he said the stuff I was talking about belonged in fairy tales and little children's books. You know, even all the science that we follow today, it's theory. Most of it, all of it, in a sense, is theory. And even the stuff we know to be for sure, along with the laws of physics in this dimension, only apply to this 3D dimension that we're in now. What about the fourth dimension? Time. What about, you know, other places in this universe? We don't know. Things that apply and work in this state of existence may very well not be the case somewhere else. Just be open-minded. I'm a very open-minded person, like extremely open-minded. I give information a chance. I'll listen to anybody's point of view. I don't judge. Everyone's entitled to feel what they feel, believe what they believe. Yeah. You're entitled. But if you're not going to listen to anybody else's point of view, it's you who's closed-minded. I won't even listen to it for 5 seconds, you know? I'm not saying that you even have to believe everything in a certain, you know, category of stuff. Chemtrails, blah, blah, blah. You don't have to believe every single freaking thing you hear. Just give the information a chance and you might find you do see the point in some of them, some things. At least part of it could be true, right? Part of it could be true. You're changing us. I believe it. Call me crazy. Call me a tinfoil hat wearer. I don't give a shit what you think about me. What you think about what I think. If you don't like what I think, okay? More power to you. To each his own. Don't sit there and be rude and cruel just because you disagree with me. It's not really necessary. Are we 4 years old? It's like people are stuck in this childish shit. I don't get it. Can't we all just get along, you know? Can't we all just share information? Share thoughts and stuff without brutalizing each other. It's unnecessary and rude. We're being lied to. If you think that we're not being lied to, it's bad. Trying to integrate us into some Borg shit. Straight up. AI is taking storm. It's quantum computers. DARPA trying its smart dust shit. It's fucking bad. We're playing God, man. Anybody out there who thinks that we haven't cloned people? I disagree. It's not that hard to do. They cloned a sheep. Back when? Way back when. You think that they can't clone a person? You think they can't clone a person? For some fucked up reasons, like harvesting their organs, if you're rich enough. Like that one movie, The Island. You know, that makes me think, it reminds me. They're showing us what they're doing. You know? You noticed? They're showing us. They're showing us what they're doing. Movies. Etc. They're laughing in our face, really. The Illuminati are all laughing in our face. You know, y'all might find this far-fetched, but we're eating our own kids. The blood sacrifice rituals, shit like that. McDonald's, okay? McDonald's. They've got this program where they take in young kids, like 14, 15, right? They say they take them in to help them. And you don't have to report, they don't have to report these kids that they get, these teens and shit. They don't have to report them to authorities or anybody. It's an anonymous thing. The kids can come and get help. These destitute children with broken homes, drugs, all that sort of thing. They can come into a McDonald's and get helped, right, in this program. And most of them disappear. So many of these kids have disappeared. I died. They disappear. Amongst so many other kids in the sex slave trade, the human trafficking trade. You know, about how they're not butchers in a sense, they're not cannibals. When they do these sacrifices of your kids, they don't eat them. They drink their blood, they don't eat them. They drink their blood and then they butcher them and sell them to all the big distributors of meat around the world, especially Western civilization. And that's why they push the sausage and beef and hamburgers. And for breakfast, lunch, dinner, sausage, hamburgers, blah, blah, blah. They push that shit because we're eating them. Your own kids get put into your local fucking burgers and shit. And what's messed up, this guy talking that I listen to, he had a point. I hate to be devil's advocate and say this, but he had a fucking point. He sat there and dissed us. He laughed in our faces because he said, you know, we can eat your kids. Or, I mean, we can put the meat, you can eat your kids. We can tell you. We can tell you we're doing this. And you don't believe us. We'll tell you the truth. And you don't believe us. We get shown the truth. We get told the truth in so many more ways than one. And we don't believe it. We deserve everything we get, you know? We deserve it. We deserve it. Everything that comes to us. If we don't work together real freaking quick. There's gonna come a time where all the people who didn't believe folks like me are gonna go shit. Maybe we should have given them a chance, given that information a chance. It's been a very humble episode, the analysis.